Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sanjay Rajvanshi. Please watch my last video to find out the solution of quadratic equation. Now in this video, I am going to explain nature of the roots of a quadratic equation. Let us assume the quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. A is not equal to 0. When you solve it, so you get the two roots. Alpha is equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. This term b square minus 4ac is called discriminant. I have to explain what is value of d here? We assume it discriminant is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now, this discriminant d, b square minus 4ac, decide the nature of the roots of this quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. The roots of this quadratic equations are alpha is taking plus sign. Then you get this one. When you take it minus sign, you get beta is equal to this one. This value b square minus 4ac, we say it is capital D, discriminant. So in place of this, we can write capital D here. Now this value of D is decide the roots are real, imaginary or distinct or equal. So here three possibilities arises. So case one, we take discuss one by one. So we take it case one. Case 1 is this, give this value of capital D, it means discriminant, it means b square minus 4ac, it is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means it is positive. So if discriminant is positive, so this factor become positive and we can calculate the easily square root of positive number. So the roots are, say alpha is equal to minus b plus root of d upon 2a. And here minus b minus root d upon 2a. Here you use the minus sign. One is plus, other one is minus. So minus b upon 2a same. So it says two roots and these rules are real and distinct. We can say finally, if capital D greater than 0, the roots of the given equation, quadratic equations are real and distinct. Real and distinct. This is your case 1. Now case 2. Case 2 is suppose this discriminant equal to 0. Case 2. If the value of D is equal to 0, discriminant is 0, so B square, it means B square minus 4 is equal to 0. So this whole factor becomes 0, here also 0, here also 0. So alpha, value of alpha is minus B upon 2A. Value of beta is minus B upon 2A. It means roots are equal. So if discriminant equal to 0, then roots of the given equations are equal. So roots are equal if discriminant equal to 0. Now case 3, we will discuss now case 3. Case 3, if D is less than equal to 0, in first case D is greater than 0, in second case D is equal to 0. Now we take it D is less than 0. If D is less than 0, it means this value become negative. Less than 0 means negative. And square root of negative is not possible. So it is a imaginary number. So it is imaginary number. So finally we can say ki when D is less than 0, then roots are imaginary. It's not real. So roots are imaginary. So finally we can say in one word, If the ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 and a is not equal to 0, so then the value of roots are depends on the value of discriminant. And here we discuss three cases: if d greater than 0, then roots are real. If d less equal to 0, then roots are again real. But in this case, roots are real and distinct. And in the second case, it is equal. So here roots are real and distinct. You can make it in the tabular form. And here roots are real and equal. And in the third case, if d is less than 0, then roots are imaginary. So finally, we can say d, the value of roots, the nature of the roots depends on the value of d. Thank you very much.